it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to feature some hairstyles using micro or mini braids. I've never done hairstyles with this type of braid before, just because it takes a little bit of patience to do them, but I think these turned out really well, so let me know in the comment section which of the styles is your favorite. Be sure to like and subscribe as always, and click that notification bell, then you'll be notified every time I post a new tutorial. So let's get started. For the updo hairstyle, I'm going to begin by designing how I want the style to look from the front. And this will help me decide where I want my braids to be. So I'm going to place one braid on the left side of my head near the top. So I'm going to divide off a small piece of hair for my braid. And I'm just going to braid this into a regular 3-strand braid. So I'm dividing the section into 3 smaller pieces. And I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand, alternating between the left and the right side pieces. And you can either cross the side sections over the middle or under the middle. I like the way the beginning of the braid looks when it's crossed under, so that's why I'm doing it this way. And I'm just going to repeat the steps crossing the side strands under the middle strand, working my way down to the bottom. And once the braid reaches close enough to the ends, I'm going to take a comb and back comb the bottom of the braid upwards. This will kind of tangle the hair a little bit so the braid doesn't unravel, and then I won't need to use any elastic bands to tie off the end of the braid. So next I want a braid at the back of my head, so I've divided off a section near the top of my head close to the crown, and I'm going to repeat the same steps as before and braid this into a regular 3-strand braid. And you can alternate the sizes of all of the braids to kind of keep them a little bit different, or try and keep them all about the same size. And then of course, once the braid reaches near the ends, I'm going to gently back comb the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to create a third braid on the right side of my head. So again, I'm dividing off a small section of hair, and I'm going to braid this into another 3-strand braid, crossing the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the left and the right side strands. And then I'm going to gently back comb the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to create one more braid at the back of my head. I want to have enough braids that they're noticeable, but not so many that it's just a bunch of braids in the hairstyle. So I'm braiding one more braid down the back of my head, starting at my crown. Once all of the braids are done, I'm going to divide off the top section of my head to be pinned as the crown section. And I'm going to twist the section together towards the left side and then slide my pin in horizontally from the left side. And I like to just hook a bit of hair on the right side and then bring the pin over the top and push it in from the left to help hold the hair in place without the bobby pin showing. And then I usually slip in a second bobby pin just to make sure the section doesn't fall loose. So now I'm going to combine the rest of my hair together and tie it off using a hairband. I want to make sure to tie off the hair right underneath the crown section, so when I do my bun, it will sit right where I want it to, and this will make it a little bit more flush with the crown section. But now with my ponytail, I'm going to braid this into another 3-strand braid. So I'm dividing the hair into 3 equal sections, and I'm going to cross the side strands over the middle strand. So I'm crossing the left strand over the middle, then crossing the right strand over the middle, and I'm going to continue this pattern until the braid reaches down near the bottom of the hair. And then once the braid reaches down low enough that the hair is getting too short to braid, I'm going to wrap it into the bun. So I'm going to take the braid and wrap it over the hairband towards the right side. And I want to make sure to lay the braid flat over the hairband so you can see the pattern of the braid. And then I'm going to continue wrapping the ends around the hairband so they tuck underneath the bun at the nape of my neck, under the hairband. And now I need to pin the bun in place. And I like to hook a bit of hair in the bobby pin and then push it in towards the center of the bun so it's against my head. I usually begin with a pin on the right side, then one underneath, and then one on the left side. And then I'll work my way around again, repinning wherever the bun feels like it needs a little bit more support. I really love how this hairstyle turned out. I feel like this bun looks a lot more complicated than it actually was, so I hope you'll try this out. Let me know in the comment section what you think about this hairstyle. For the half up hairstyle, I'm going to begin by dividing off the hair that I want to use for the half up portion. So I'm going to divide off the hair starting above my ears and bring this towards the back of my head. Then I'm going to decide where I want my first braid to begin. So I'm dividing off a small section of hair on the left side of my head towards the hairline, and I'm going to braid this into a regular 3-strand braid. I'm going to cross the side strands under the middle strand, alternating between the left and right side strands, and I'm going to repeat this pattern, continuing the braid until it reaches down near the ends of the hair. And once it reaches far enough, I'm going to take my comb and comb upwards towards the end of the braid to keep the braid from unraveling. This will kind of tangle the ends of the braid. And now I'm going to create another small braid on the opposite side of my head. So I'm dividing off a small section on the right side of my head and braid this into another 3-strand braid. And once the braid reaches far enough down the section, I'm just going to gently backcomb the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to create a third braid closer to the hairline on the right side of my head. So again, I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand, alternating between the left and right side strands until the braid reaches down towards the ends. Then I'm going to gently backcomb the end so it doesn't unravel, and that way I won't need to use a clear elastic band. Now that the three base braids are done, I'm going to create the half up portion of the hairstyle. So I'm going to divide off the hair above both of my ears and bring it around to the back of my head. I'm also adding in the braids last so they don't end up buried underneath other hair. And with this top section of hair, I'm going to create a little bun. So I'm going to twist the hair together and wrap it into a spiral going clockwise. Now I'm going to pin the bun in place using some bobby pins, and I'm going to work my way around the bun, sliding the pins in against my head so they catch a little bit of hair from the bun and then hide underneath the hair. But now I'm going to create a few more braids underneath the crown section. So I'm going to divide off a section of hair on the right side of the bun and create another 3-strand braid, working my way down to the ends. And now I'm going to create another braid on the left side of the bun. So I'm dividing off a section of hair and creating another 3-strand braid. And once the braid reaches the end, I'm going to wrap it around the bun and pin it at the base of the bun using a bobby pin, just so it looks like my bun has a braid in it. So once that's wrapped and pinned, I'm going to create another 3-strand braid to replace the one that I wrapped around the bun to kind of fill in that gap on the left side of the bun. So I'm picking up a section on the left side and I'm going to braid this into another 3-strand braid, working my way down to the ends, crossing the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the left and the right side strands. And then I'm just going to gently backcomb the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Working off the last hairstyle, I had to include a ponytail just because summer is coming up and I think ponytails are such a great hairstyle for the summer. I'm going to keep all of the braids in place from the half-up style and pull all of the hair up into a ponytail. So I'm going to combine all of the hair together while trying to keep the braids out on top of the other hair. And now I'm going to create another braid in the ponytail itself. So I'm dividing off a section and I'm going to braid this into a 3-strand braid. I'm separating the section into 3 smaller pieces and I'm going to cross the side strands over the middle strand and working my way down to the bottom of the section. And now with this braid, I'm going to use it to hide the hairband. So I'm going to wrap the braid around the hairband a couple of times, and then using a bobby pin, I'm just going to secure the braid underneath the ponytail at the nape of my neck. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know in the comment section which of the styles was your favorite. Be sure to like and subscribe as always. Click that notification bell, then you'll be notified every time I post a new tutorial. And I will see you next time.